Sustainable energy is of vital importance in developing sustainable smart cities for our future generations. Hello, I'm Professor Minhua SHAO from the Department of Chemical and Biological Engineering, also the Hong Kong UST Energy Institute, and also the founding director of the Sustainable Energy Engineering Program, or called SUSE. Today, I'm here to give you a brief introduction to this exciting program. The SUSE program was launched in the 2017-18 academic year by the Hong Kong UST School of Engineering. We had 16 students admitted in the first cohort in 2018. SUSE is not like a traditional program, but an interdepartmental program based in the School of Engineering. It's managed by the Department of Chemical and Biological Engineering and supported by three other departments, including the Department of Civil and Environmental Engineering, Department of Electronic and Computer Engineering, Department of Mechanical and Aerospace Engineering. This program is also supported by the Hong Kong UST Energy Institute and will be accredited by the Hong Kong Institution of Engineers. Probably you have heard about the energy crisis. We need energy. It's required for the effective and efficient operation of our society, from the provision of utility, communication, transport, and etc. So actually, energy is listed as number one in the top 10 problems for the next 50 years. Probably you will argue that we still have the sun, right? The solar energy is endless. But the problem here is how to use and store the solar energy. If you look at this chart, the energy consumption has increased significantly since the Second World War. The primary increase coming from the fossil fuels, including coal, oil, and gas, that contributes to about 8% of the total energy supply. The problem of the fossil fuels is that they generate carbon dioxide, which is one of the greenhouse gases. The increase of the greenhouse effect will cause a lot of problems, including the melting of the ice, increase in the temperature of the earth, and it will cause severe climate change and air pollution. In addition to these problems, the resources of the fossil fuels are limited and will be used up at the end. So we need to develop and utilize clean and sustainable energies for the future of our next generations. Renewable energies include hydroelectricity, solar energy, wind energy, wave power, geothermal energy, bioenergy, tidal power, and nuclear energy. The problem here is that a lot of these energies are intermittent. For example, in Yunnan province in China, more than 80% of the hydroelectricity is wasted. We need to find a way to restore the electricity. The solar energy and wind energy are also intermittent. During the daytime, you can use the solar energy to generate electricity, but you cannot do that at night. But the requirement of electricity is actually all day long. So we need to develop technologies to store energies. For example, batteries, pumped hydro, compressed air, and etc. Hong Kong actually also tries to promote renewable energies. There is a program called the Renewable Energy Feed-in Tariff. If you install the solar panel on top of your roof or somewhere else and successfully generate electricity to the grid, CLP will buy the electricity and pay a higher price than the market. The objectives of the SUSE program are to nurture leading professionals who can design and implement energy systems to respond to the expanding global environmental and energy needs. Our mission is to provide a strong multidisciplinary curriculum in energy engineering that will well prepare students for careers focusing on the energy solutions, including energy generation, delivery, storage, and efficiency. Potential employers include government departments, consulting firms, local and international engineering industries, and postgraduate programs. There are a lot of unique features in this program. For example, it focuses on both traditional and renewable energy technologies. And the interdisciplinary curriculum is designed to teach fundamental knowledge of power generation, conversion, distribution, and consumption, optimization, and management. So you will have a general understanding of energy conversion and storage, and also can focus on specific technologies like solar energy, wind and hydropower, batteries, and fuel cells. We have a lot of elective courses in this area. The students are exposed to multiple engineering disciplines, including chemical, civil, electrical, building, energy, environmental, mechanical, and materials. We also provide abundant internship and industry training opportunities, which will be provided by the four departments, not only from the chemical and the biological engineering. We also provide a specially designed sustainable energy lab course, which will be offered by the four departments. For example, the chemical and biological engineering department offers the fuel cells and the lithium battery lab courses. The electronic and the computer engineering department offers the solar energy lab course. And the mechanical and the aerospace engineering department offers the wind power course. This is an overview of the curriculum structure. During the first year, students will take the engineering fundamental courses, including physics, chemistry, math, and computer science, and of course, some of the common core courses. In the second and third year, students will take the energy core courses. A lot of these courses are from different departments and divisions. MECH is mechanical and aerospace engineering, CNG is chemical and biological engineering, ELEC is electronic and computer engineering, CIVL is civil and environmental engineering. We also have our own course, ENEG, both in core and elective course categories. Students also will take the energy policy course offered by the Public Policy Division. Elective courses are divided into four categories. Category 1 is energy generation. Category 2 is energy storage and distribution. Category 3 is energy utilization. And Category 4 is sustainability. We also recently introduced an investigation project. If you are interested in conducting research, you can take that as an elective course. And of course, in the final year, we have to conduct a capstone project that is offered by four different departments. We also have a 120-hour tailor-designed industry training. I also listed some of the academic advisors from chemical and biological engineering, mechanical and aerospace engineering, electronic and computer engineering, civil and environmental engineering, and the chemistry departments. So it's a very multidisciplinary advisory team. Students can choose any of them as their academic advisor and talk with our faculty. If you are interested in knowing more details about the program, or if you have any questions, you can contact me directly by email or phone. Our Sustainable Energy Engineering program is suitable for students who want to become professional energy engineers, playing a role in creating engineering solutions to build cleaner cities for our future. I hope I can see you soon at our Sustainable Smart Campus. Thank you.